Lighter's up, Virgo. What's going on? It's the Stoner Girl Tarot back again. Roll up with me, light up with me, drop down in the comments. Let me know what you're smoking on. If you don't smoke, no worries. You're still more than welcome. What's going on, Virgo? This is some, it's a sativa strand called Privy, P-R-I-V-Y. So I hope you are well. I hope you are safe. This is for Virgo, the Virgo Collective, and the Cross Watcher. Bottom of the deck, the Moon in reverse. A Cancer could be significant. Feminine energy, mother energy could be significant. This is something, this is the energy of something being revealed to you. So this is something that is coming towards you, Virgo. Possibly for some of you, it's basically information that you've been wanting to find out for a while that could become. So let's see what this is about. Be sure you click that subscribe button and notification bell to be notified of my next video, because my posting schedule is all over the place. Okay, so King of Wands and Page of Wands in reverse, and then we have the King of Swords in reverse and the Hanged One in reverse, and the Ace of Wands in reverse for you, Virgo. Definitely Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy. This is also Pisces, Libra, Aquarius, and Gemini energy. Honestly, some of you don't see the fact that someone is, if they're coming towards you, or if they will, it looks like they will. This person is coming towards you for sexual satisfaction. They're sexually motivated. There's manipulation here. And Virgo, if you are doing this and you think the other person doesn't know, more than likely they know. Okay, for some of you. Some of you have, something has really like hurt your feelings, or this is like, I'm gonna show you energy. Someone could have attacked some type of idea, or especially if you are a creative, they could have shot down an idea that you have. And so with all of these in reverse, the Page of Wands, the King of Swords, the Hanged One in reverse, some of you are like, okay, I know my idea needed some work, but you didn't have to shoot me down like that. Some of you are slick offended because you are a Virgo, and Virgo will plan and strategically execute how to do something, or they will plan and then they will execute the plan, and that's how they, a lot of Virgos are successful. They stay consistent. So some of you are offended because you're like, I'm Virgo. What do you mean I can't do it? What do you mean I can't be successful? What do you mean I can't be the King of Wands and create the type of life that I want for myself? What do you mean? And these are your haters. Fire energy, air energy, and Pisces energy here. Again, you know, someone, people are thinking, you know, you're flighty. Some of you are talking about quitting a job or giving up something, sacrificing something. And people are wanting you to look at this more realistically. People are wanting you to look at this love situation more realistically. We'll get more into that. But yeah, it's like people have been counting you out and you don't appreciate it. Tell me more. Okay, well, you see how that landed. Yeah, they don't think that you can be this. And there's someone that believes in you outside of you. Could be a Taurus. This could be someone that you had some type of romantic situation with, and they could have had like very nurturing qualities to them. Doesn't have to be a woman. Take it how it resonates. But this is what this card is about. It's about birthing something, giving life to something. So this energy is coming to you. Damn. Page of Pentacles fell on the floor. It fell upside down, so I'm not really sure how to read it, but it feels like my spidey senses feel like this could be someone where there was like a rejection in the past. Maybe you rejected this person or they rejected you. But it's like this person, you're either thinking back on what this person told you, thinking back on what this person may have, instructed you or gave you an advice on what to do. And maybe that is causing you to look at this person differently or vice versa. If this isn't you, feeling like you got something to prove, then this is the energy of you, Virgo, saying, something is triggering you to look at this person differently. Yeah, looking at them as a suitable partner, a viable partner. Maybe you didn't look at this person. This is like, the energy of you've been friends with this person for a while, or you've always kept this person in the friend zone, and you're looking at them differently now, or they're looking at you differently. I hope I'm making sense. But yeah, it's like, if this ain't you up here, like you on a vengeance, you got something to prove. Or maybe it's a mixture of the two. Like you've shown someone what you can do, or you're trying to prove yourself to someone or like a group of people. Who is this person Virgo is dealing with? Fire energy, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, somebody that there was some type of loss. Yeah, a breakup, or y'all just stop talking, y'all just stop dealing with each other. But now this person feels like there's a good chance that they can make plans to come towards you. Something's holding them back. The stars in reverse, they don't feel hopeful. Aquarius energy. Why is that? They feel like you are happy without them, or you're just happy with someone else with the Ten of Cups here. How does this person feel about Virgo? Have a suspicion that you're not talking to this person. Maybe you haven't talked to this person in a while, but this person feels like whatever effort they put into, trying to reconnect with you or work things out with you, it's not gonna happen. It's not gonna work. They want to, though. They just don't feel that they can. What action do they want to take? Because this Knight of Wands came out, like I said, they want to come towards you. But the two of you could have had like a real major fallout. And they are like Seven of Pentacles. Like, what's the use? And so this person may be trying to, they could have used this energy as motivation to like improve themselves, work on themselves. Hoping that, you'll see them in a different light. Or this is, you realizing like, this person wasn't so bad. Maybe I can work things out. Maybe I can talk to them, reach out to them. I don't feel that they will reach out to you, Virgo, because you've somehow, some way, you've given them this feeling this belief that ain't nothing happening. You may not be talking to this person, like I said. What's the obstacle here? You could be already in a commitment. Maybe you think they are in a commitment. Maybe this person feels that you're in a commitment. Some of you, the obstacle is someone doesn't want a commitment. And so someone here has spent a lot of time going back and forth, trapped in their thoughts. Someone just doesn't know if they want this person like that or not. Quite plainly, like, I don't know how else to say it. What's the outcome? I feel like even though there's sadness and there's regret here, there is, this is Sagittarius energy, so there is hope as far as like there being some type of resolution here. Someone maybe, you know, praying or doing some type of manifestation rituals. Yeah, to start a new beginning with the World card here. This is Aquarius, Leo, Taurus, and Scorpio energy. So someone wants to work things out with you, basically. Let's draw some channeled messages. And not telling you what to do, Virgo, but this person doesn't feel like they have a chance with you. So if you are wanting to reconnect with this person, you're going to have to be the one to reach out. You could be dealing with an air sign, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. This person wants you to tell them how you feel. Maybe this is you, Virgo. You want them to tell you how they feel. It hurts me that I hurt you. If you're looking for something to say, that could be something that you could say, or maybe this person will tell you that. Someone is lying. So, bottom of the deck was that moon in reverse. So something could come out. You know, maybe they were not honest with something, Virgo. Maybe you were not honest. What was that about? This person may not be in a relationship, and that's what is coming out. And you think that they're with someone, or they think that you're with someone, Virgo, because it has to be a reason why you're not reaching out. Okay, that's how someone feels. Like, there has to be a reason Virgo isn't reaching out. Yeah, someone is standing their ground with the Emperor here, Aries energy. Someone has set like a boundary, and I feel like for some of you, you feel like if you reach out, you're breaking a boundary and you're not putting up with that. Like, you're not gonna allow that person to make you break your own rules. Like, you know, you're not going to allow this person to cross a boundary again. So leave me a comment, let me know if this has resonated, and I'll see you later.